So we're talking about that big skull in the center first. Can everyone see it okay?
Mm-hmm.
Zoom in. All right, so that belonged to a type of animal we call a peccary. Peccaries look like wild boars. There's going to be a group passing right behind us, so you guys don't worry about them. Just keep looking at these bones over the top of them. You guys see those big front teeth on that skull? Those were its tusks. Those tusks were used in self-defense and to help them dig up things that he ate. See, it roots in certain plants. Around him, we got these leg bones. You guys see how a lot of those bones are broken down there? Can you guys guess why his bones are all broken up?
Falling.
Exactly. So you're going to fall pretty long ways down to get here. So a lot of leg bones from all types of animals are broken like that. So let's start behind the peccary. Oh, there we have another type of animal skull. That belonged to a fisher. Fishers look like big weasels. They don't live here in Indiana anymore, but you can still find them farther up north where it's cooler. Places like Canada and Alaska. Similar to how the environment was like here in Indiana. You guys are still.
What's on there,
Tom? Whack.
That's your head there, too.
They put a lot of work into this.
Oh, yeah.
Man, they put a lot of work into this.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive what they did. Everything that you see was actually done in about a year.
Wow.
And damn. It's not like we had a whole army of people working on this. It's only a handful. About a dozen guys working on this. Because it's not like a construction company that's going to build you a cave. Just, I guess, some either crazy people or people who had experience. So, it's pretty cool.
Tell us what you're pressing here for.
In this area, basically, all these bones that we see, these were kind of discovered on accident. So as we were building this cave, putting this walkway, they had to dig up some of the dirt. And in this area, they found a lot of bones. Some areas, it was about 50% bones and about 50% dirt. So half and half.
Yeah, like
that. Yep, right there. So right after construction, a paleontologist came down here. So this is the first kind of official dig that was professional dig that was started in our cave. Right? As you can see, he found lots and lots of bones. In this particular area, all the bones that have been found, they all belong to peccaries, right? Now, the reason we have so many peccaries in our cave is because in nature, peccaries like hanging out in caves. So down in South America and Mexico, there's a lot of peccaries in those areas, and there's a lot of caves. And people observe that peccaries still like hanging out in cave entrances.
We've been in underground caves in Cancun, the underground cenotes. And
that's cool.
We swam in underground cave, or underground caves. It was incredible.
You guys go cave diving by any chance?
No. Well, we didn't do cave diving per se, but there were the caves we were in, you were able to dive under and go.
Are they like beginning of sinkholes or
well, there's cenotes that you that you can access. Some of them, you know, when you get down into them, you can look up and there's a hole where you can see where animals would have fell, and a lot of fish in them. They're all connected underground with rivers, and they say there's over 5,000 cenotes in the Cancun area there, and underground caves are incredible.
I'm actually getting my open water dive certification here in a couple weeks. Eventually, I want to do cave diving.
We did go scuba diving in the ocean and seen some pretty cool fish and stuff like that. And
yep.
While we were there. We were in the jungle. We seen those big pyramids,
Chichen Itza.
Take a look, guys. Smile.
Awesome.
Oh, I want to eat because my battery's too low.
Can't see you.
Now, all the bones that we have down here, they're all very fragile. First of all, everyone actually already saw that big hole in the video that you watched. This is that part where those cavers push through that.
Crawdaddy.
Yep, people call them crawdads, crayfish. Some people call them dinner from Louisiana.
Yeah.
Some people call them bait.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is a northern cave crayfish. He spends his entire life down here in the cave. Eats, sleeps, reproduces, does everything down here. He cannot survive on the surface. That little guy is completely blind. He actually has no physical eyes on him. But even though he is blind, he has a very developed sense of feeling heat in the water. Right? They're hard to see. You guys can maybe see him. He has these very long 75 ears. So it's pretty cool. That right there is a baby cave salamander. If I could have some of you guys actually come to the other side of me, that way the folks in that room would be better. So So the crayfish, big crayfish, they can eat these little salamanders we have. So this is called a cave salamander. The cool thing about these little guys is they don't have to spend their entire life down here. If we were to take that little guy, which is kind of cool, this little guy eats basically the same. Is there anything kind of weird about those bones that you see up there?
There's not. For a bear.
Not really.
That's not the answer I was looking for, but...
They're disconnected?
Yeah, we only have the skull right here.
Yeah,